This problem is a graph question, and from the section it comes from, you know it's a parabola, but another way to know it's a parabola, one variable is squared, the other variable is a first power. All right, the x variable is squared, so what we're going to do is look at the cheat sheet, and I want to see when x is squared. That happens right here. X is also squared here, but if you notice on this one, there's no plus or minus anything. So unfortunately, we have to go with this more complicated equation. So I'm just going to grab this whole bottom row and rewrite it right down here. All right, so now we have this whole bottom row, and what we're going to do is take our equation up here and copy it down below this equation. All right, so our equation was x plus 1 squared equals 16y plus 2. All right, we have to figure out what h is. Now, I'm supposed to be subtracting here, so I'm going to force subtraction with minus a negative 1. Normally, we don't write like this. Typically, we would simplify this minus negative 1 into what's above, but in this case, I really need to get this form. So we're forcing into that form. All right, 16, I want to write it as 4 times a number. So 16 is 4 times 4. And we're going to play the same trick on the plus 2. I need to have it subtracted. So we're going to go minus a negative 2. So now we're ready to write down all the letters here. H is negative 1, A is positive 4, and K is negative 2. And if these negative ones are tricky to see, just think I want to see what K is, which is the thing that's subtracted. I want to see what H is, which is the thing that's subtracted. So it's a little tricky to pull H and K out of that first original equation form. All right, once we have all this written down, we can now go in and fill in the vertex focus directrix. So the vertex is negative 1, comma, negative 2. Focus is h is negative 1, a plus k is 4 plus negative 2, or 4 minus 2. Directrix, y equals negative a, it's negative 4 minus 2. So that's y equals negative 6. 4 minus 2 is 2, and vertex is just what you see. We can go over and grab the axis of symmetry, x equals h. So our axis of symmetry will be x equals negative 1. And we're going to open, is it up or down? So for us, it depends on if a is positive or negative, r is going to open up. All right, so let's take all this information up to the graph. I'm going to zoom out for a minute while we fill this stuff in. Vertex, negative 1, negative 2. Let's go green on our graph. All right, so we got negative 1, negative 2. So it's left 1, down 2. That's the vertex. All right, the focus is negative 1, 2. So that's left 1, up 2. That's the focus. Now, the focus is not a point on the graph, so I did not fill it in. Directrix, y equals negative 6. Let's go ahead. Fill that in. Might as well make this red also. All right, so the definition of a parabola, it's going to be all points that are the same distance between the focus and the directrix. The easiest point to see is the vertex. The vertex is 4 units away and 4 units away, so it's right in the middle. All right, the other points are a little more tricky to see. So the only other point, at least for me, that's even a little bit easy to get is the point that's going to appear somewhere on this line right here. So that line I just drew, how far is it away from this horizontal line? We're going to go up 6 and 2 more, so that's 8. And then the other way we measure, I need to be 8 away from this. So we're going to go 8 to the right. It's going to end up right here. That's 8. So all that work was just to say that there's a point here. That point I drew, again, is 8 away from the focus and 8 away from the directrix. You get a very similar point on the left. If you go left 8, now we're going to have a slight problem because I'm going to run out of room here. So it's way over at negative 9. Now I'm going to clean up our graph. Actually, no, I'm not. Let's just overwrite with pink. I like all this stuff on here. I don't want to get rid of it. I'll just make all this graph stuff pink. All right, and we just connect them together. There we go. There are other ways to get this graph. I didn't have to get those two points. I did that based off the definition of a parabola. I could have searched for the x-intercept. How do you find the x-intercept? Well, you carefully set y equal to 0. X-intercept set y equal to 0. So you would get x plus 1 squared equals 16 times 0 plus 2 and solve for x. So that's how you can get your x-intercepts, but in this case, I just used the other two points to get this graph.